смерти. Спасение, Господу помолимся. Многие же предавши им разум, завиша к темницу, завещавши темничному стражу, первые священники, ниже такого завещания приня, садитесь во внутреннюю темницу, и ноги их забит в плане. Полуночи же Павел и Сила, молящиеся по ясно Бога, послушав уже их юзницы, внезап уже труд быстрели, якобы колебастися основанию темничному, отвергоша жеся, авие двери вся, и всем юзы ослабеша, возбудшийся же темничный страж, и видев отверстие двери темницы, извлек нож, хотящий себе убить, меня избегша юзники, возгласишь глазом велием Павел Благоря, ничтожится твори себе зла, си бо есть мы здесь, просил бы свящи скочи и трепетен дух, приходи к Павлу и Силе, и изверг их воне рече, Господи, и что не подобает творить, да спасуся, он ожерек прихоста, веруй во Господа Иисуса Христа, и спасешься ты и весь дом твой, и глагола стоимо слово Господне, и всем я же в дому его, и поем я в той же час ночи, и мы от ран, и крестися сам, и свои, ему все авие, есть же я в дом свой, постави трапезу, и возрадовайся со всем домом своим, верова Богу.
In those days, as the apostles went to prayer, a certain girl possessed with the spirit of divination met us, who brought her master much profit by telling fortunes. The same girl followed Paul and us, and cried out, These men are servants of the Most High God, who show unto us the way of salvation. And this she did good for many days. But Paul, being with her, and I turned to the spirit and said, I command thee in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her. And he came out that very hour. But when her master saw that their hope of profit was gone, they seized Paul and Silas and dragged them into the marketplace to the authorities and brought them to the magistrates, saying, These men, being Jews, exceedingly trouble our city, and they teach customs which are neither lawful for us to receive, neither to observe, being Romans. Then the multitude rose up together against them, and the magistrates tore off their clothes and commanded them to be beaten with rods. And when they had laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into prison, commanding the jailer to keep them securely, who, having received such a charge, put them into the inner prison and fastened their feet in socks. But at midnight, when Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them, suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were opened and everyone's chains were loose. And the keeper of the prison, awakening from sleep and seeing the prison doors open, supposed that the prisoners had fled, drew his sword and was about to kill himself. But Paul cried out with a loud voice, saying, Do thyself no harm, for we are all here. Then he called for a light and ran in, and fell down trembling before Paul and Silas. And he brought them out and said, Sirs, what must I do to be saved? And they said, Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved, and thy house. And then they spoke to him the word of the Lord, and to all who were in his house. And he took them the same hour of the night, and washed their stripes, and immediately he and all his were baptized. And when he had brought them into his own house, he laid the table for them, and he rejoiced with all in his house, believing God.
Peace be unto you.
And to thy spirit.
Wisdom.
The holiday is in the eighth tone. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
steps to thou direct according to thy saying.
Исповедь Христа, облучен сон еще да будет. Сигурагина дни прибыли Кюста, Джикоста, яко возраст им от самого вопросите, возгласи же жарторицию человека, и живе слепо рече ему. Дашь славу Богу, мы вем, яко человек сей грешник есть, отвеча же он и рече, аще грешен есть не вем, иди на вем, яко слеп ты и не же вижу, треща же ему паки, кто сотвори тебе, я как у отверзи очи твои, отвечаем, ты Бог вам уже и не слышите, что паки хочете слышать, и дай вы ученицы его хочете выйти, а не же укориша его и реща ему, и ученик и того, мы же Моисеевы есть ученицы, мы же вемы, для Моисеевы глагол Бог, всего же не вена, откуда есть, отвеча человек речей, о всем по диво есть, яко в невесте откуда есть, ты отверзи очи мои, вем же яко грешник, Бог грешник и Бог не послушает, но аще кто Богу Отец есть, и более его творит, того послушает, в ответ и не слышно, как кто отверзи очи слепу рожденному, аще не ты был не сел от Бога, не смог бы творить нынче сожа, отвеча же рече ему, во Христе ты родился и севесь, и ты ли не мучиши, из нашей го вон, услыша Иисус, яко из нашей го вон, и обрете его рече ему, ты веришь ли в Сына Божия, отвечая он рече, и кто есть Господи, да верую в Него, рече же ему Иисус, и видел еси его, и благое с тобой то и есть. Он же рече верую, Господи, и поклонися ему. At that time, as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was blind from his birth, and his disciples asked him, saying, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Jesus answered, Neither has this man sinned, nor his parents, but the works of God should be made manifest on him. I must work the works of him that sent me. While it is day, the night cometh, when no man can work. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world. When he had thus spoken, his head on the ground, and made clay of the spy, and he anointed the eyes of the man who was blind, and said unto him, Go wash in the pool of Siloam, which is by interpretation sent. He went his way therefore, and washed and came seeing. The neighbors therefore, and they which before had seen him, that he was blind, said, Is not this he that sat them back? Some said, This is he. Others said, This is like him. But he said, I am he. Therefore they said unto him, How were thine eyes opened? He answered and said, A man that is called Jesus made clay and anointed mine eyes, and said unto me, Go to the pool of Siloam and wash. And they went and washed on the sheep's side. Then said they unto him, Where is he? He said, I know not. They brought to the Pharisees him, and after time, that a fourth time was blind. It was the Sabbath day when Jesus made the clay and opened his eyes. And again the Pharisees also asked him how he had received his sight. He said unto them, Lay upon my eyes, and I work. And do you see? Therefore said some of the Pharisees, This man is not of God, because he keepeth not the Sabbath day. Others said, How can a man that is sinner do such miracles? And there was a division among them. They said unto the blind man again, What sayest thou of him, that he hath opened thine eyes? He said, He is a prophet. But the Jews did not concern him, and that he had been blind, and received his sight, until they called the parents of him, who you say was born blind? How then does he now see? His parents answered them and said, we know that he is our own son, and that he was born blind, but by what means he now sees, we know not, or who has opened his eyes, we know not. He is of age, ask him, he shall speak for himself. This word spake his parents because they feared the Jews, for the Jews had agreed already that if any man did confess he was Christ, he should be put out of synagogue. Therefore said his parents, he is of age, ask him. Then again obeyed the man that was blind and said unto him, if God the Christ, we know that this man is a sinner. He answered and said, whether he is a sinner now or no, I know not. One thing I know, that whereas I was blind, now I see. And they said to him again, what did he choose to thee? How open to thy mind? He answered them, I told you already, and he didn't hear. Wherefore, what he hear, it again, who knew also be his disciples. And they received him and said, thou art his disciples, but we are Moses' disciples. We know that God spake unto Moses, unto this fellow, we know not from whence he is. The man answered and said unto them, why carrying this marvelous thing, that we know not from whence he is, and yet he has opened mine eyes.
Lord, have mercy,
and again we pray for his kingdom, always now and unto the ages of ages.
This land is full of glorious and armed forces, and the people that dwell therein may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always now and ever and unto the ages of ages. That God preserve Russian land and her Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always now and ever and unto the ages of ages. His beatitude and Ufri, Metropolitan of Kiev and all Ukraine and his suffering flocks. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always now and ever and unto the ages of ages. In the hope of resurrection and life eternal, may the Lord God remember his newly departed servants, Archbishop Gilotheri, Bishop Arkady, Stephen, Nina, Maria in his kingdom, always now and ever and unto the ages of ages. The priesthood, the monastic order, those who are persecuted and suffering for the Orthodox faith, the founders, the benefactors, the brethren, the sisterhood, and the singers of this holy temple, and all you Orthodox Christians, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always now and ever, and under the ages of ages.
Yes. Well, I guess it's better received that than the backs.
Thank you.
ourselves and one another, and all our life unto Christ our God.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil.
Thank you. Christ is risen.
Indeed he is risen.
Christos Christia.
Christos Christia.
Christos
Christia.
For most of us, that is the last time that we will hear those words today, this year, in the church. We've come now, brothers and sisters, almost to the end of this possible period. This Wednesday, Tuesday evening and Wednesday morning, we'll celebrate the bright week services once again, as is the practice on the leaf taking of Pascha. And then, on Wednesday evening, we celebrate the vigil for the Feast of the Ascension, and the Paschal gifts are no more. Until, and at last, the Lord gives us another year, when we get to hear them again. When we come to this point, we are often sad that we have missed opportunities to be in the church and to sing the Paschal hymns and to hear them and to rejoice. God willing, next year we will also have the opportunity to do that. Somehow we have to put a reminder in our mental calendar today that we will remember next year, this year, that is next year. I need to be more often at the services during this bright, bright time. But we're not quite yet finished with Pascha. And each Sunday of the year is a small Pascha, and so we don't have to despair, most certainly. Today, the Holy Church provides for us a very edifying account from the Gospel of St. John the Theologian. It's a rather long one, as has been the case for the last few weeks, as we are celebrating the feast and more often in church. The Holy Church gives us a little bit longer Gospels to ponder and to listen to and to learn from. Let's have a look now at today's Gospel and see what we can use here, what the words of the Lord are teaching, not just those who were around him then, but also us and all those who will come after us in the Holy Church. Here we see that the Lord heals a man who was born blind. He was blind from his youth. And he heals him, and right away the apostles come and say, who sinned? Was it him or was it parents? His parents, that this man was born blind. In a way, we are very much in the place of the apostles today, or they are in our place, however we want to think about that. How? We think we've got it all figured out. We're pretty sure we know how to do everything, and we're pretty darn smart, and everything kind of goes the way that we expect it to, and that happens, then this happens, and I'm in charge, and everything is good, and I'm in charge. Well, the honest fact of the matter is that we are pretty smart. The Lord didn't create us as dummies. At the same time, when we think we got it all figured out, we can be pretty sure that we don't. And the apostles in today's gospel show us that that's the case. They had it all figured out. If somebody's sick, that means either that person sinned or his parents sinned. And that's true most of the time when you listen to what the Lord is saying and how he's teaching the apostles. But not always. What does he say here? Neither did this man sin nor his parents, but that the works of God may be made manifest in him. That is, that God may be glorified. Now we can look at this and say, that's interesting, moving on. Or we can say, that's interesting, maybe there's something there that I need to learn. Let's go for the latter. We think that we've got it all figured out. We're pretty sure we know everything that's going to happen, and we can control it all. But when that doesn't happen, consistently, maybe someday we'll learn, it should be for the glory of God. But we should say, oh, I thought I had that figured out. I remember in that excerpt from John that was read on the last day of Pascha, the apostles also thought they had it all figured out, and they didn't. And that was for the glory of God. So this can be for the glory of God, too, if I will just give this to God and accept the peace that comes from it. We say all the time, I want peace. But we act all the time like we don't want it. We do everything we can to not be at peace, and then we bemoan the fact that we're not at peace. First important spiritual lesson. When there's a problem, the person you're looking for is in the mirror, most of the time. We have to accept the fact that we don't know everything, that we can't control everything, and that if we will just give the things that we can't control to God, it will be for His glory, and we can have peace. Because there are certain things, brothers and sisters, that are above our spiritual pay grade, right? At your job, there's probably a hierarchy, right? There's not very too many sort of purely commons workplaces out there where everyone is supposedly equal. There's some sort of hierarchy. And you know when you kind of hit the top of yours, and you say, now I pass it off to the next person because I can't really do anything here. This is out of my bakery. But somehow in the spiritual life, you feel like, well, this is not like my work. I'm in charge of everything here. God listens to me. He does what I want. And when He does, then I praise Him. And if He doesn't, well, you know, that's His problem because I certainly couldn't be wrong. That's probably not a good, spiritually healthy place to be. Rather, we should, when things don't go according to our wisdom and our plan, hand that off to God and say, God, give me what's best for my salvation. Let this thing be for Thy glory, and let me be at peace. If we could do that, brothers and sisters, even make a small effort in that regard to humble ourselves, we would really receive peace. We would really stop worrying about things that we have no control over and wasting all of that energy that could be used to do good, to pray for others, or maybe to just do the chores of your wife that have been asking about for the last 3 weeks. But we spend all that time worrying, how can I fix this problem, which I obviously can't fix, and how can I fix this problem, which I obviously can't fix, and at some point, we just should give it to God. The apostles are often a great example for us in our spiritual lives. That's the case here today, brothers and sisters. We know a lot. The Lord became incarnate to teach us what we need to know to attain the heavenly kingdom. But there is a limit to our knowledge and our wisdom. There is no limit to God's knowledge and God's wisdom. And perhaps He gives this to us as a sort of obedience, so that we learn to be obedient by learning that we do not control everything. St. Pia von der Recluse says that humility is what can bring us to God. But the only way to that is through obedience. If we can see these things that we can't control, that we can't oversee, that we can't have every sort of possible power over, as an opportunity to immediately give them to God, then that helps us greatly with our humility, which we need very much. We don't have many opportunities for obedience in our spiritual lives, brothers and sisters, if we're honest. Those who are married, they have obedience to their spouse. All of us have obedience to the Holy Church, mostly through fasting and prayer. And sadly, we often kind of give up on those, but we should not give up and we should continue to struggle. And here, when something is out of our control, we can see this as a sort of obedience which helps us to embrace humility. And with humility, brothers and sisters, the Father's say, comes peace. We say we want that peace. Let us start acting and ordering our lives so that we will have it more often. And the more often we have it, the easier it will be to find it, through returning to that humility that we gain through these obediences of fasting and prayer, and especially of giving up those things to God that we cannot control ourselves. If we can do that, brothers and sisters, then as we are exiting this possible period, we are picking up a very important spiritual precept. Humility brings peace. May the Lord grant you both. Amen. knowledge or in ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thy most pure mysteries for the remission of my sins and unto life everlasting. Amen. Of thy mystical supper, O Son of God, accept me today as a communion, for I will not speak of thy mystery to thine enemies. Neither like Judas will I give thee a kiss, but like the thief will I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. May the communion of thy holy mysteries be neither to my judgment nor to my condemnation, O Lord, but to the healing of soul and body. Amen. Veruj, Gospodi, ispovedaju, jako ti jesi u istinu Hristos, Sin Boži, Pao, prišeli mir vešni je spasivati, že veri je za nas. Ješe veruj, jako si ja sam ispričisto je tijelo tvoje, i si ja sam nečesna je krop tvoja. Molim se pre tebe, pa vidi mi, a ne prosti mi prekrišenje moja, bolje mi bolje. Ja će slovo mi že djela, mi že djeli ime ni vedini. Ispred ovi mi je mi osuđeno, počestiti se prečisti tvoji tajnost, uostavljeni ili klopo počisti dešći. Amin. Večeri tvoji temeni su mi Bože pričasnika i pričasnu su mi na primi. Nebo prakom tvojim kajom Bogem, bilo za njim i tam jako Juda. Nekako razbojni ti stvoreni priča, po njim je gospodi od sadosti tvoje. Dani su bili osuđeni, ako bi učišenje je sveti tvoji taj gospodi, na ovoj se zemlji duši i tijela. Amin. After we receive the antidote and kiss the cross, and please take our weekly bulletin and Sunday reading donation of $7 for adults, for over students and guests, and children need free. Most important is that you be with us, brothers and sisters, not so much about the donation, but we'll use it if you got it, for sure. Our new mask rules are almost gone anyway, but we're asking those who are not vaccinated to wear masks, and those who are not vaccinated, that's up to you whether you wear a mask or not. Some of us are better than us in any case. On July 1st, all those will go away. All those will go away, so there'll be no mask requirement in the church until further notice, and hopefully forever. This winter worship space, got its new name of weekend worship space. Father Vladimir came up with that. And that's good because even if you don't really love that name, and I'm not saying it's bad, we're out here after July 1st. And all the services will be in the church. If we're going to do the festival, which I think we're going to do, and we're certainly going to try, we need the space for that. So I know we're going to be a little bit missing this place, so a few more weeks here. But then we'll start with the 7 o'clock early liturgy in the church, and then 10 o'clock early liturgy. We'll try that for some rest of the summer and see how that works. Maybe it'll work, and maybe it won't, but we'll keep trying. Registration for Ann Arbor Orthodox Classical Academy is open. The information is on the doors. Please have a look at that and please spread the word. Our Matthew 25 efforts, parish efforts continue. You can see Bill Edwards or Abby Lang coming to meet here, Captain McDaniel, or you can see me to learn more. We're trying our best to feed the hungry, to house the homeless, and more, so please join us. Special services and activities this week, Tuesday evening and Wednesday morning. That's the last half apostle services of the year. So Tuesday at 6, Wednesday morning at 8, and we serve those like right here. So please glad to join us for those wonderful and beautiful services. And then Wednesday evening at 6 o'clock and Thursday morning at 8 o'clock, we celebrate the great feast of the Ascension. So please join us for that as well, brothers and sisters. The work on our parish school continues. Floors were put in this week. You may have noticed that we have some new sidewalks around the church. A lot of things happened this week. So thank you to all who are making that possible. Please help if you can, volunteer, donate if you can, but most importantly, pray for the success of the project. Fasting this week is Wednesday and Friday, so please make note of that, and remember that we mentioned that in the sermon, and how important that is to help us with our obedience. Cemetery spaces are available. Please make your reservation if you haven't done so soon. You can see me, or Jack, or Constantine today. Any other announcements? Okay. So, Jack, you want to mention about the lawnmower? So, the way the lawn mowing kind of grows here at St. Vladimir's is we have volunteers who mow the lawn on Thursday. And then because of all the rocks and bricks and I don't know what else they throw in the grass, but it takes to throw in the grass, all the lawnmowers are half destroyed. And on Friday, Sergey Duco begins welding, so we're ready to mow again on Thursday. So first we'd like you to ask you to please have an eye on the kids and ask them not to throw, we had some extra papers left over from our project last year. Those were getting thrown in the grass. So anyway, please ask the kids to not do that. But nonetheless, it's not fun to be a volunteer if your stuff doesn't work. And so parish council decided that we're gonna get some good lawnmowers. We're gonna get some real professional grade lawnmowers for the volunteers. And those are not cheap. We're getting two new lawnmowers, and the whole thing comes out to about $17,000. $17,500, okay. So please, brothers and sisters, be generous when you come to the cross, and make a donation to help offset this cost. We could have gone on the same way we were, but volunteers are not going to last if we don't give them things that actually work. So we kind of came to this place in our parish where we need to take care of it. Now, those lawnmowers will probably be mowing my grave, right? That's the kind of machine it is. It's going to last forever, as long as we don't keep throwing things into the grass so much. But even then, it'll probably still last forever. So we feel like parish council feels like this is a good buy, and we're important for us to do that. So please be generous with us. If today is not a day for you to do that, you might have to Jack about that. Or you can talk to Mikhail Fisikov, and he can back. He's in Russian law. First time in some time, but we'll be coming back to some other announcements. Please.
I just want to thank you all for that time to stop and come to me and to Marina and the volunteer to help out around the church. It really means a lot. I really appreciate it. There's so much more we can do if we all just get it up. And I'll be back to that. The other thing is the
Parents, keep an eye on the kids. That's a big temptation over there, that nice glass space. It wouldn't be good if they were running along there and breaking stuff because it's pretty expensive stuff. So please help.
Everybody leaves when they go to church. Just walk along. As you walk along, you can see the branch for just pulling the rocks and kids in front. Just cross over to the side of the building and work on the ground. We don't do that once a week. That's what these machines will last. It's that by themselves. They're commercial grade. That's what professionals use for the last six months.
So thank you. Other announcements. Jeff is lingering here, but we don't need an announcement.
Well, I would like to
congratulations to both of them. Condolences to my wife, who realized that she spent more than half her life with me already. And I'm sure my mother's prophecy is coming true. When we run to my parents and ask me that blessing to get married, my mother just extemporaneously, or maybe she had been rehearsing it for months, I don't know. She said, if you marry me, please. So I think that's happening. So please keep praying for her. It's not easy to get married. Other announcements before we sing many years for those who had their names days. Okay, let's do that. Let's sing many years. Our alum Constantine had his name's day this week along with all of our Helens and Yelenas and sing. Yes, he abandoned us and went to Italy, but I said this week as well. And also Dimitri Kamuska had his name's day this week. He's not named after the same Dimitri as everybody else is named after Dimitri. So let's sing to them.
Thank you.
Christ, our true God, who rose from the dead, to